When we are working on any programming language or we are having any database or data where we are storing it, so we generally come across a scenario where we want to delete certain types of data or certain data after a period of time, after the expiration of something that we don't want after a year or month, or you may have a multiple time frame for that. So for this, you either you need to delete it manually after a period of time, or either you will create a process or coding, programming or application which will delete it automatically. So DynamoDB provides us a solution for this. So I am Anjali, you are watching Smarty Tech Fizz. Welcome to my channel. Namaste everyone. So we are talking about the expiration of the data. So DynamoDB provide a process where we can delete our data after the expiration defined for them. So this is called as the expiring items by using DynamoDB time to live. So this is a document given by the Amazon itself for the DynamoDB, and there is a topic for expiration of it. So what it does, we will provide a TTL to a table which it will check and delete it after that expiration will done. So it will be the backend process. It will not take you any extra charge for it, no throughout charges for yourself. And but there are some important points we need to take care of it before configuring the TTL process. So in this part, I will be only explaining you some important topics, important notes before configuring it. Then in the next part, we will be continuing it with the configuration. And there will be the third part also where we will be defining some concepts which we are learning here. So let's get start with that, how it works and how what are the important points we need to take care of it. So you can see this is expiring items with time to live in DynamoDB, that is called the TTL in DynamoDB. So what we have in important points is, firstly you can see that when it is only used when you don't have when there is a certain items which you don't want after a certain period of time. For example, maybe you are storing some logs of your application servers or some request or response logs in your DB. You don't want it after a year or 2 years, then you may define TTL here that okay, delete these items after 2 years of its storage. Okay, so you can define TTL here. Or either you can have like user sessions, user processes like in the database, which you want that after 2 years of this process, it must be deleted. After 1 year of this process, it must be deleted every data from this particular user or session. So this can only be used on that scenario. So next part is delete. When the TTL is deleting your items, it actually does not consume any throughput for it, and it will not any take extra charges for you. So it will be beneficial for you. So the third point is, okay, so when you are configuring the TTL, okay, you must define an attribute name. I have taken all the points from the DynamoDB documentation given by the Amazon, so you can find all the points here itself. So I'm just giving the small view of it, that how we are doing it. So third point is that when you are defining the TTL, then you must be defining a attribute on which the TTL should be occur. So if it does not have, let's say you have defined the TTL, okay, let's enable the TTL on certain table, but on any attribute you don't have that, on the attribute on which you're defining the TTL, if it is not there, then it will ignore the TTL process. Okay, so let's say you have a expiration date column in expiration, you are enabling the TTL on the expiration column, but the expiration table is not expiration column is not available, so it will just ignore it. Okay, so you must have the attribute specified in the table. So now next is, if the TTL attribute you are defining, it should be of number type. No, if it is of string type, let's say expiration date column you have in your table, then you can see in the example given by the Amazon, let's say this is a expiration time TTL which you are defining on the table, but it should be of number type, okay? But agar if it is of string type, then it will ignore it also. So it should be of number type. Next is TTL attribute value must be time step in, okay, the value you are providing for the TTL attribute, it should be of unique epoch time, that is the time in seconds, okay. Epoch time is a particular type of time you are providing it, no other type of values it will be taking care of. So now next part is, it will not take the value of expiration more than 5 years. So it is the most important, one of the most important point of it, that let's say you have, you can see here, they have defined a example, like let's say you have set the value of attribute is this, which means February 17 of 2007. Then if it is older than 5 years, it will not going to take care of it also. It will not delete that particular data. Let's say you have a table, okay, you have multiple values, you enable the TTL and certain any row having a value of expiration time more than of 5 years, then it will not delete it. It will not work on it, okay. So next point is, any changes in TTL setting will take up to, if you, let's say you want to provide any changes to the TTL settings, let's say you are enabling or disabling the TTL settings, it will take 1 hour to be work on it, okay. So it may take time, maximum 1 hour, it will do it in the minimum 5 minutes, any time it will take, but maximum it will take the one up to 1 hour. Next, it could not reconfigure it, any TTL you could not reconfigure it. You should only be, firstly you should need to disable it, this one, and then re-enable with the different attributes. Like if you want to change the expiration attribute value to some other column, you firstly need to disable the first configuration, then you will re-enable it but using the different attribute. We will see in the next part at how we are going to define an attribute value for TTL. In the next part we will do it. So if you are changing it, you need to firstly disable then re-enable it. And next thing is, if you want to restrict any updates from unauthorized person or unauthorized access, you can take care of it using the IAM policy. If you are using any MAC services, you should be knowing about the IAM, identity access management. By using it, you can restrict the people's, okay, any updates. And these two three points are very important. You should take care of it before having a coding or developing any TTL on any table. So these are the points, like let's say the actual delete operation of an expired time can vary. Okay, let's say you have a data in your table that is very large, okay. So if due to the very large data size or activity on the your table, it may take to delete your items more than expiration time. So in that case, what you need to do is, that is mentioned in the next part, is actually what happened is, the TTL process is a background process, it's just going on in the background only, so it may take time to read, like a batch process, a stream process, it is taking care of it, so it may take time to process it. So when the items which are expired but haven't yet been deleted, so what happen if, let's say, expiration is today, okay, it should be deleted by today and up to 10 p.m. but now it may take time and it will delete by 11 p.m. okay. So then if in this range of time from 10 to 11, if you query it, it will give you the result. It can appear in the read, queries and scan. So for this, what you need to do is, you must use the filter expression. If you don't want to, your data should be coming that expiration time is actually gone and it is still not deleted, then it you should use the filter expression for filter the items which are having which should be deleted now. So what is the filter expression you should be doing? You will be providing like expiration time should be less than current time. Okay, see that it is also provided here that to do this use a filter expression that returns only items where the time to leave expiration value is greater than current time. Obviously, if you want a data where the value should be less than the today's time, because the expiration time is until today, until current time, and if it is greater than the epoch time, that is that expiration time, that should be occur only. If it is already passed, it should be deleted. So you should use the filter expression. We will do this part in our upcoming next part. So you can skip it for now if you are not understanding right now. But the main thing is, you just if you are having a coding experience, you must be knowing that using the if conditions. Okay, where you may define the condition as, okay, the given time should be greater than the current time. That is the only condition which we need to define in the filter expression also. Okay, next is as I said that read queries and scan can appear even if the item is not deleted and expiration time is already completed. So in the same way, you can also delete items or can be update items or update on that particular items which expiration time is completed. So this is the main thing. Now, if you want to enable TTL, there are two ways to enable the TTL. One is via console via CLI. For the console part, you can see the document given by the Amazon, because I am not going to perform enabling on the console, because if you are a developer and you are on a testing phase or developing phase, you must be installing the DynamoDB in your local system. So on the local system, it will be better if you are doing on the CLI. On the console, the steps are given in the document itself, so you can see there. And you can see that steps are given here for the console. I will be doing only for the CLI part. So we will be enabling on using the CLI. So this one more thing. Actually, I said that earlier that the expiration time should be in the epoch time format. There are simple methods to get the current time epoch in different languages, like in Linux terminal you can get by this, in Java you can get by this, in JavaScript if you are using, you will get by this the epoch time format. So there are formats given here for getting the epoch time format. So you can use that values for inserting any item in the table. So we will doing the configuration in the next part. So till then, keep learning, keep watching. Take care. Bye bye.